Hey guys, welcome back to Vanilla Minecraft. Oh yeah. So the iron farm is working. I mean it's not as fast as I wish it was. Wish it was like 20 times faster, but there's no way that I'm going to make 20 more of these up in the air. But that is actually what I could do. You could build this exact thing 32 blocks up in the air. Oh, there's an iron golem. Let's go check him out. These fences are to stop mobs coming in here and killing me if I'm AFKing. I was AFKing down here just to see what the drop rates were like and such like, but yeah, there we go. So he's dead. Let's check it out. We have 43 iron. That's not too bad. I have not actually, you know, AFKed here for any length whatsoever, which is really cool. So this thing is working. It should theoretically be working wherever I am on the server. Exception possibly is spawn, but I'm not sure about that. Let's just fill the bottom row with poppies and leave this go. So guys, let's head back to the base now and we'll get started on what I want to do today. So guys, a long time ago, we have some new fields here and over here and over here because I had to set up new fields because I needed a lot of food to get that villager farm working, or the iron farm. So a long time ago, we set up this chunk here, which is our slime chunk. And we never actually finished this thing because the slimes don't get killed automatically. What level am I in? 6. That is fine. 3. Yeah. Cool. Yeah, so the slimes don't actually get harvested, which is pretty annoying because getting slimes in here is actually super difficult. Like, seriously super difficult. So we want to just set up an automatic killing system. We don't really have the resources to make a like collection system for it, but that will be okay for now, to be honest. If we're looking for slimes, we should be able to come down here and there should be some like every time we come down. That might, like, I might be wrong on that, but yeah. What we want to do is just take out 3 wide blocks over here. Hopefully we pick up some more iron. There's one piece there. So yeah, we want to just take out the whole row along here, and eventually we'll have we might have to take out some bedrock here as well. Why is the bedrock coming so far down? I didn't think it was meant to come down up this far. Should we have actually made this up one more? We probably should have. I don't know which is going to be easier now. Just taking out the couple of things of bedrock, or... Anyway, it's not for now. We don't have to deal with that right now because we are going to just... We're going to just automatically kill these guys and then we'll just drop down here like every 5 minutes if we're looking for slime, and we can just pick it up. Should be easy. Also, if we actually set this thing up properly, we could probably set this up actually. I'm just thinking about it out loud, and we might be able to do something anyway. Let me just finish taking out these couple of rows of stone and I'll come back in a second. Okay guys, we're back down here. I was going to move the whole thing up one block, but then I decided, screw it, I'm not doing that. Mainly it's because this stone axe is crap and I've literally used all my iron to make this rail and stuff. But we do have a small collection system going here, and I mean small. Like, this is barely going to pick up anything, to be honest. It should pick up some of the drops. So what we want to do is use these new magma blocks to do the killing of the slimes. These will damage the slimes. We'll get those coming into these in a minute. We'll probably just do this amount. I was gonna do the full row, but then some of them won't get hit. What's the, no, it's this, yeah. Of course, I have to bring this back. So we're gonna have a minecart. There it goes. We should be able to just come in here and grab out any of the slimes then. Let's just check this out. Whoops. Oh no. Did it stop? Oh, now it stopped. Cool, so that does work, which is fine. Let's put this back. If I had a trapdoor, I'd put one there. Actually, that would be an idea. But we'll leave this off for now so it's not annoying me with noise and stuff. So what we want to do now is probably get rid of this stuff for the moment. We'll just cover it up for now. Oh yeah. So we want to attract them over. So we're going to put down some fences here. And we're going to push a iron golem in here, which is why we needed the iron, of course. Let's just, I think that should be okay. So we just want to push the iron golem into here. And that's why I wanted the pumpkin that last episode. Oh, I have a feeling that you have to, yeah, I think this block has to be gone. Let's get rid of that. And let's get rid of this block here. And I think that should form it then. Yeah, so get in there, please. In you get, in you get. Oh, he can't fit in there, of course, because the back wall. Let's not hit him, hopefully. Let's put some fences down there now. Now, he should fit in there, yes. Oh, head height. In you get, come on. The corners as well? No? No. Okay. Okay. He's mostly in there. Let's get rid of these corner ones as well. Put fences in there. And here as well. Fences there. So that should... Oh, no, 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 no. Not up there. There we go. Perfect. That's what we're looking for. So that guy is in there now, so we can probably seal him in a bit better. We don't have to see him again, honestly. Yeah, there we go. Perfect. We'll probably just let these blocks despawn. Sweet. So in terms of iron golems, right. So the slime should be attracted to this guy. We're just going to seal him right in so that... Oh, that's as good as we can get. That should be okay. Cool. So this guy should now make the slimes come towards him. Let's yeah. Yes. Okay. Cool. And then for now we are just gonna use some cobblestone probably to seal in this bit. And then I gotta go get some more fence posts to seal this guy in. So let's put down the cart. And I'll also get a trapdoor. We'll put the trapdoor there. So this should now be picking up some of the drops here. We can actually put some glass down up there. No, I think fences should be fine. So let's leave that for now. Let's just seal this in. And hopefully that now will start automatically collecting these guys. But we'll see in a while. I'm going to go get more resources, mainly, of course, fences and stuff. And we'll come back in a second and see if we've gotten any slime balls or anything like that. And then once we have everything set up, I'm going to just AFK a bit. And we'll see if this actually works, because we need slime balls, honestly. So cool. Cool. Yeah, all right. So it picked up pretty much all of the slime except one, which is nice. Let's just check this out. Only two slimes. Ugh. But yes, it works. Now the thing was, that slime didn't start moving until I walked towards him. So I might have been just too far away. I was AFKing out this way, where my unharvested diamonds are. I haven't harvested these yet because I'm waiting to get some fortune. There's a good few patches of them, which is really nice. Like, there's no need to get diamonds. I get this axe from a villager. So if I go out here and just come back here, and I've marked torches here at 32 and 24. So maybe if I stand at the 24 block, it should start spawning stuff anywhere out there, and they should be moving as well. So I'll leave this go for a bit more, and we'll come back in a second. Okay, guys. So I got a decent haul at the moment. Obviously, we can let this run for a while more, but I've 26 slime balls now, which is pretty nice. I have noticed a lot of them drop like here and over there, which is pretty annoying, but for now it will do until we either remove the bedrock or just raise this whole thing up one. So what are we gonna do with this? You're probably asking. That's kind of the whole thing. We want to get started making some machines that use slime blocks, and of course, as some of you might know, some of the main machines that use slime blocks are flying machines, and I wanted to make a farm using slime blocks and flying machines. So let's just grab some observers, and we'll grab some pistons. I think I went back to the iron farm to grab some pistons. To grab some iron so we can make some more pistons. And we have some observers already, and we already have one slime block, which is nice. And let's just grab a flint and steel so we can trigger these things. Let's make some pistons now. We're very low on wood. Oh, and redstone, of course. Cool. So let's just head outside for a minute. Yeah, we've loads of time. So let's go over here just for a second. We might need a furnace or something to stop these things. Yeah, I can probably make one. Ugh. Furnaces are unmovable, of course. There's a squid over there. Hi, squid. So the farm that I want to do is sugarcane. So I want to use a flying machine for harvesting sugarcane, because I think that's cool and different, really. And I you know, just decided to harvest some sugarcane right now as well. So let's grab some blocks, and let's just go up a bit. Let's see if I can just... I probably need to have sticky pistons, I think. And we'll also need at least one more slime block. But I think... let's just create this up here. So, like, the basic idea, I think, is just to do... this... and then this. And then we need observers. And I think, oh wait, is it this way, isn't it? I think. That's observing, uh-oh. Ooh. The hell? Oh, ghost blocks. This isn't actually moved, has it? Ooh. Let me do a relog. Oh no! Oh no! Whoops! Oh no! Well, that's something. Yeah. Let's just put a block over here and let's send this thing back. Wow. So yeah, that kind of worked, except not exactly what I wanted it to do. Oof. Is this on? I think we want it on this level here. So, oh, that's hilarious. Oh, no, that's not what I wanted to do. I wanted to update this, but I don't seem to be doing this right. Oh, that's hilarious. There we go. Going back again. Should stop there. Okay, now I'm left with a whole ton of oh no. Well, oh, this is bad. This is very bad. Oh yeah. We should probably do this in some sort of room that's like fully enclosed with movable blocks. Let me go sleep and fix this thing up before it burns to the ground. Okay, guys. I don't want to talk about this. This. Oh, yeah, that just went really bad. Let's just lower this so stuff doesn't spawn up there. Oh, we're missing some water as well. Although that is an idea of something that we could do. Is use a machine to kind of push all the trees together. That could be cool. But anyway, this is essentially the machine here. Pretty simple in terms of what we need. Yeah, let's just I don't know how we can. We just do this to get it going. Yeah. So as you can see, oh, hang on, we have to repair it then. That's going the wrong way though. And of course we're getting a ton of ghost blocks. Don't know why. Oh, we can just right click them and they go. Nice. Okay. Good to know. Can we put a torch on top of a torch? No. So we want to, let's trigger just an update up here. Wrong way. We want to do this one. There we go. So yeah, so it moves along and it pushes out these things and we'll have like a wall along and then we can just, or we can have a two ride stream and it just should push them all down there and then we can just make it go back and go the other way. So it's pretty simple. And we can make this like as long as we like, basically. Within reason, the fact that we can only push water so far, but I mean, a small bit of loss. I want this thing to be really long. And we can, like, look how much sugarcane I've got here. I want this thing, so it can do two rows as well. We can do another row over here, so it can do two rows. We'll just click all these and get rid of them. And then we need a return thing at the end, which should automatically just return it. And I think we can do that with a... Let's see if we can get up here. So we can have another observer just here, which should power this. And then if we have a piston on top of this, or if we make it a sticky piston, although it was zero tick, won't it? Let's see. We'll put this here, and we'll put just a block, doesn't matter what the block is, here. And that way we can actually manually do it as well. So that goes that way. And let's, hopefully if this updates here, oh, it doesn't. Oh, I thought that might update like that. We might have to use a repeater or something. I thought, is this, how quickly does it tick? It's like almost instant. Can we just put another piston on it? I don't know if that works or not. No, okay. I think we probably have to get a repeater on there somehow. So let me make a repeater and stuff, and we'll see if we can make this so that it just keeps going back and forth. That would be cool. And of course I had the observer the wrong way around. That is why. That's super annoying in terms of that. But yeah, we should be able to just put a torch here, and yeah, there it is. So this thing should, I've built the return station on the other side now as well. It didn't work. Did I have it the wrong way? Oh, this should be sticky. Yes. Sticky. And then this should actually go when I... Yeah, there we go. Cool. What is with all these... zero ticking. Yeah, no, we will have to put in a put a repeater in here. But I have some repeaters here, so we can probably do this repeater here the other way. Ugh. I have so many blocks now around the place. I don't know which ones are ghost blocks, which ones aren't ghost blocks. That's a ghost block. And we could probably just put a redstone up here for now. Oh, seriously, the amount of redstone. Let's just kill off all of that. So, okay, that should be fine. So let's just... It's very hard to tell what is meant to be here and what's not meant to be here. Okay. That seems to be everything, right? Let's just try to get up here and put a block on top of this and see if it goes back. No. It's still... Oh, I think we need to... increase that. Oh, I think it's now just broken, right? Yeah. Yeah. No, I think it's just broken now. Like, that is not meant to be there, and that is not meant to be there. Let's lose these ones from now and see if we can just get it returning. So, need more blocks. You know, I'd really love to be able to fly to get this thing in. let's get rid of this and this. And observer here. This way. And slime block here. And we just need to put the other piston here. We can put it here for now. And then we can just update that. And then when this is moved, it should... There we go. Okay. Right. We've got it going this way. And that's not going to update it, of course. So let's just... So this, will this return? Oh no, I forgot the block up there. That's sigh. Yeah, okay. Can we just trigger that again? Why don't I have any, where are my torches? Okay. And this should do it now. Yeah, okay. So that one's working. And then we can just return this one ourselves. Dropping that there, and now it should come straight back. Yes, excellent, cool. So we can do that like that. It should be simple enough. I noticed there's no ghost blocks when these things aren't on the bottom, so maybe that's affecting that somehow. You know, having these here is making this kind of a bit messy, but oh, seems to have worked okay that time. Oh, we lost one of them though. That's weird. And that's real. Interesting. Okay, well, that's kind of the basic idea. I'm gonna have to work on this off camera, and hopefully next episode we can come back and get this thing up and running. So guys, I'm gonna leave it there for now. Hope you enjoyed the episode. We got a slime farm automated. Hopefully it should be gathering slime right now. We could probably go look, but I think we're pretty much out of time. You know what? Let's have a quick run just to... Oh, no. Just see how much slime we have, if we have any. We probably won't have any now, will we? Oh, 17. Nice. Yes, so this will passively grab it. So cool. So guys, I'm gonna leave it there, and I'll see you next time.